No? Okay. Just me. Right. Aha.
Oh, very clever. I just got it.
Okay, this is the MCM Birmingham Comic Con Cosplay Masquerade, ladies and gentlemen. I know you're not here to take photos of me, but it still feels good to have all those cameras pointing at me. I'm looking at you. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Obviously, we want lots and lots of support for all of our lovely cosplayers who have been very patiently waiting. So without any further ado, I think we're going to get going. And we have a couple of little kiddie cosplayers to start this off. So we have, coming up on stage now, we have Hiro Hamada from Big Hero 6. And his trusted sidekick, Princess Cadence from My Little Pony. As an extra award, they have been given a secret phrase to go and use at Tokyo Toys, because Tokyo Toys likes to give a little present to all of our kiddie cosplayers. So big thank you to Tokyo Toys for their generosity with supporting the kiddies in the Masquerade. Now, we were going to have another kiddie cosplayer, a stealth operative, but they're so stealthy that we can't find them. So no number two. And we're going to go on to our junior cosplayers. And we're going to start that with Jessica, who's here as Black Widow. Widow from Marvel Avengers. She was questioning what the holdup was with the Masquerade, and I had to explain, that's show business, darling. That's show business. Our next junior cosplayer, I believe, will still be performing, but they're on their own now. We have, it's Emily, isn't it? It's Psycho Anarchist coming up on stage as Gumi. No, as Miku. Psycho and Kiss coming up on stage as Miku, the Vocaloid. Yep, she will be performing.
You need the microphone. Yeah. Keep it very close to your
mic. I know, yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Got the packaging, it's not the time that they were hiding with me. Tell me more, she if it couldn't like it.
Psychonic is there, as Mika for vocaloid, and an extra clap there for going ahead with the performance, even though her partner for it was ill. So doing it solo after practicing as a duet, very well done. Okay, no number five, OTEC team. So we'll move on to number six. Our next junior entry is Ellie, and they're here as Yuno Gasai from Mirai Nikki. Lovely stuff there. Ellie there, as you know, Gasai. Mirai Nikki is coming out at the moment on DVD for Manga Entertainment. If you're looking for a happy slice of life anime about, you know, coming of age of a group of high school kids, this is not the one for you. If you liked Elfin Lied, might be more your scene. Okay, that's all of our junior entries, I believe. We do now have another performance for you. I'll be taking the mic. It is Katie Richmond Cosplay is going under the sea today as the beautiful Ariel from The Little Mermaid.
Maybe he's right. Maybe there is something wrong with me. I just can't see how a world that makes such wonderful things could be so bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got oozits and whatsits galore. You want thingamabobs? I've got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. Wanna see I'm dancing, walking around on those, what'd you call them again? Oh yeah, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, taking a stroll down a, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run. Be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on the sea? women, sick of swimming, I'm ready to stand. I'm ready to know what the people know. Asking my questions and get some answers. What is a fire? How white is it? What's that word? Burn. When's it my turn? When
that's Katie Richmond cosplay there, who actually has a mermaid costume to go swimming in as well, says my notes. That there's worse jobs to have for an aquarium is than swimming in the tanks as a mermaid. And she was there, of course, as Ariel from The Little Mermaid. Oh, that tasted purple. We have Oh My Eggs here as Bittersweet Lulu from the smash hit MOBA game, League of Legends.
Pleased to meet you. They aren't gonna like this.
It's just over there. It's okay, we rescued your cake. That was Oh My Eggs as Lulu from League of Legends, the one-time support who now dominates in mid lane and top lane. Okay, this next one is a bit of a double act because we have Kelvin Coates coming up on stage as Dragon Ball Z's most useless character. No, not Krillin, even worse than that. He's coming up on stage as Yamcha, in the clutches of Vegeta Junior. So yes, at least in Zed, Krillin actually ended up less emasculated than Yamcha, as Vegeta definitely moved in on that territory. Anyone big DBZ fans? Or did none of you get the Cyberman reference there? And right, our next cosplayer, coming from a Western comic rather than an Eastern one, we have Steven coming up on stage as the Ghost Rider. As, of course, not just a comic book character, but Nicolas Cage's greatest film role, right? Anyone? No? I can't be the only one that watched those films. No number 11, OTEC team. Which is a shame, because they've written an essay for me to read. Ah. Now, I'm sure a few of you have seen this next costume striding around the event. We have James from Living Statue Cosplay as the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Dino Megazord. Stay on stage at least for the chorus. That's James from Living Statue Cosplay, as of course the Dino Megazord from Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, which is another movie that we're greatly looking forward to, just like the new Ghostbusters films. None of these can possibly go wrong, right? Our next entry took a wrong turn after Nebula Sector Y and somehow ended up in Birmingham. This is Cornerian adventurer and dogfighter, well, foxfighter pilot, Fox McCloud. There as Fox McCloud from Star Fox Zero, and I get a memento. Nope, that's mine. My present, not my present. Actually, it looked like a landmine, so maybe I don't want it. Another one for you League of Legends fans. We have a performance now from Minachi as Heartseeker Oriana and Yumi-chan as Sweetheart Annie from League of Legends.
Thank you.
Minachi and Yumi-chan there as Oriana and Annie from League of Legends. Our next cosplayer is Neo Crisis Cosplay, here as Pan, the last Tugwell from Nintendo's Fire Emblem Awakening. Crisis Cosplay there as Pun from Fire Emblem Awakening. It's probably the best Nintendo 3DS game that I haven't played yet. You know why I'm laughing, don't you? If you think my nickname of Granny Gertrude gets a few sniggers, coming up on stage now we have Rainbow Poopzilla as Alexstrasza from Blizzard's World of Warcraft. To ask about where that nickname came from at some point, but that was Rainbow Poopzilla as Alexstrasza. Coming up on stage now, it's a character that I think most of the audience will be familiar with, but possibly a slightly different version. We have Miss Green here as Madam Ivy from the Batman franchise. Of course, a Victoriana-esque Poison Ivy. Are we ready for another performance? We have Jack as Link from The Legend of Zelda. It's dangerous to go alone, and this proves it.
There would have been time for such a word. Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to day. Our yesterday's lighting fools tomorrow's the way to dusty death. Out, out, brief candle! Life's but a poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage, full of sound and fury. An idiot who has heard no more, signifying nothing. I'm sorry.
I knew it. Music was from Martin Elico. That was Jack as Link from Legend of Zelda. The the idea, the inspiration for that performance was dying over and over again against the final boss on Skyward Sword. No number 19, I'm afraid, Otech Desk. So we'll go on to number 20. Her magic will tear you apart. It's Pokawai as Jaina Proudmoore from World of Warcraft. Pokawai there as Jaina Proudmoore. Will you follow me one last time? Jace as Foreign Oakenshield, Kaiten Sushi cosplays as Philly, and Ravensong cosplays as Killy. Jace, Kaisen, Suji, and Ravensong cosplays theirs as three of the dwarves from The Hobbit, of course, but judging from the audience reaction, you all knew that. This is another entry for the League of Legends fans. We have a League squad with twice the salt of the NA servers, but way more cute girls coming on stage now. League of Legends, Hex, Tech Janna, Heartseeker Orianna and Annie, and of course, best of all, a reverse Annie, where the giant teddy bear is dressed up as the little girl and vice versa, which is definitely the best skin for that particular character. Axel of Evil Cookies Cosplay is here as High Inquisitor Darklore from Professor Layton versus Ace Attorney. Axel there of Evil Cookies Cosplay. That was Inquisitor Darklore from the game that proves that there are some dark arts involved with making computer games. Professor Layton and Ace Attorney mashup. Who would have thought that would have ever been a thing? From the fantastic anime Excel World, we have Jinx as the beautiful Black Lotus, straight from the accelerated world, Burst Link. 果てしない空を行く Jinx there as Black Lotus. Bonus points to anyone else that can anyone that can tell me which anime shares the same setting as Excel World. Come and find me after, because I can't hear you because you don't have microphones and I do. It's just bonus points. I don't know what you'd do with that. Okay, our next cosplayer is Ryan, and he's here as the ever-popular Cloud Strife from Final Fantasy VII. Ryan there is Cloud, with, of course, the Buster Sword, his best known sword. No number 26, I'm afraid, Tech Team. It was someone from Attack on Titan. They've clearly been eaten by a Titan. So we'll move on to another League of Legends cosplayer. This time we have Nicolu coming up on stage as Rengar. As Rengar from League of Legends. We have an original character, an original design next. Rex is here with his own original character. It is the Infinity Monk. Original character, the Infinity Monk. Whereas now we have Joe here as the Jedi outcast Kane from Star Wars. That's Joe as the Jedi outcast Kane. And now coming up on stage is my lovely girlfriend. She does exist. She features near superhuman patience and understanding, putting up with my rubbish. Right. Our next cosplay entry, however. We have Junor cosplay coming up on stage now as Fawn, the animal fairy from Disney Fairies.
Animal groups have all kinds of fun names.
Really? Like, what else?
Aha! I'm glad you asked.
Well, geese live in a gaggle and coyotes in a pack, and a group of jellyfish is called a smack. Here's a rookery of seals and an army made of ants. By the seashore, you can find a gulf of cormorants, zeal of zebras, hover of crows. Lions are prides, as everyone knows. They're quivers of cobras and shivers of sharks, and an exultation is a group of larks.
Wow,
She really rehearsed this.
You've got prickles full of porcupines, consortiums of crabs, and a loveliness of ladybusters looks so fab. A kaleidoscope of butterflies, a scurry full of squirrels, and this load of hippopotami are happy girls. Your gifts of puffins, geese of raccoons, stand-up flamingos, troop of baboons. A group of bugs becomes a clash, but rhinoceros can make an even bigger crash. Now, here's the one and only Never Beast.
Never Beast?
Never Beast?
Never mind. Tell you later.
Do you know cosplay there as Fawn the Animal Fairy? With an educational song, as it turned out. Our next cosplayer is James, and they're here cosplaying their favourite character from Rise of the Guardians. Watch out for Frostbite, it's Jack Frost. There we go, James there as Jack Frost from Rise of the Guardians. From the second Mulan film, we have Chloe, Fear, Sophie and Anna coming up on stage as Mulan and the Princesses of China.
May we discuss this? A princess must make every sacrifice for her country. It's our duty. The life of a princess from her birth is well defined. She must humbly serve her country, play the part she's been assigned. She guards the hopes of her people, weak and mighty, rich and poor. Who could ever ask for more?
Who could ever ask for?
Who could ever ask for more?
I wanna be like other girls, climb up a tree like other girls can, just to be free like other girls. Get to be
when I sit, to eat a whole cake, feel the sun on my feet.
Get dirty,
my silly.
Be anything I want to be.
Dance around
in my underwear.
To run really fast, to get rid of this man.
To eat a whole cake.
Get crazy
with frosting.
No escorts,
no manners,
no nursemaids,
no worries,
no hands folded perfect.
Like holding a lily.
No pinchy shoes.
I wanna be like other girls. Straight up my knee like other girls can. Just to be free like other girls. Get to be.
To speak for myself.
To sing way off key.
There is someone I've met who loves me for me.
No escorts, no manners, no nursemaids, no.
It's Mulan. Mulan and the Princesses of China there. Molly and Jenny are coming up on stage next to dominate the bot lane. It's Janna and Miss Fortune from League of Legends.
As a child, you would wait and watch from far away. But you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you'd lay awake at night and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream.
Molly and Jenny there as Jana and Miss Fortune. Right, just give us a moment. We've been asked to plonk a table into the middle of the stage.
Oh, hello.
I just found a strange tribe leaving behind the projector as well. Right, roughly in the middle, like about there. Has he given us a thumbs up? He's not even looking. Yeah? Yeah? Looks good? Okay. Look alive, wage slaves. Presenting the Caliph of Clowns, that mogul of Montebanks, the one and only the Joker. Thought I was going to end up with a 52 card pickup in my face. People familiar with the card trick, the 52 card pickup, it's where you throw a deck of cards at someone and they have to pick them up. Shall we? I thought that was quite a Joker-esque magic trick myself, the 52 card pickup. Right. Okie dokie. Just a couple of entries left now, and then our judges from amongst those who chose to compete will be selecting some winners from us. Coming up on stage now, Loki of London and Hawksom are here as Princess Nuada and Princess Nuala from Hellboy 2. Yes, that was Loki of London and Hawksom as Nuada and Nuala from Hellboy 2. And our last entry, we have Five Team Prime here as Halo Spartans.
Hello.
Okay. Now, obviously, not everyone that comes up on stage, myself included, chooses to compete, but some of them do, and they would have been interviewed earlier today by our lovely judges, Lulu and Sophie, who even now are deliberating about who to give some prizes to. But of course, many people choose to come up on stage just to show their costumes off and just to give you a good look at them. So before we worry about winners, let's have a big round of applause to all of the cosplayers that have been brave enough to come up on stage today to entertain us. Absolutely lovely of them. We will have a masquerade tomorrow as well. If you wish to take part, come by the cosplay desk. We're just outside. Come by tomorrow, not once we finish here. But if we can just hold on just a moment, because we'd love as many people as possible to be here to congratulate the winners. The costume prizes go on basis of construction and accuracy, largely, although there are a few points sprinkled on the top for their time on stage. Then the judges will also be selecting someone for their performance as well. Of course, funnily enough, performance is the main element there. How are we looking? They're scribbling furiously, but they don't look like they're arguing. That's a good sign. Is anyone else as tired as I am right now? It's been a long day. You've enjoyed Birmingham, though, yeah? It's been a good show. In case you were wondering around and going, is this bigger than last time? Yes. Yes, it is bigger than last time. We needed more space. Have you found it a little bit less cramped? Have you liked the extra space? Or is it not enough extra space? You sat there going, I didn't notice any extra space. I was still rammed. People were treading on my toes. No. How are we looking, ladies?
Almost ready then?
Yeah, right now.
Okay. They will. Oh no, you can come up on stage and announce it. You don't have to write it for me. Yes, come up on stage. They don't want to come up on stage. It's not like you haven't been up on stage before. I remember your Dizzy cosplay. This cannot be as awkward as that. So that's Google Lulu Rose Dizzy costume. No? So just bear with us one moment. They're just writing down the last names. The people lurking in the doorways, there are some empty chairs, you know that. You could take the weight off your feet. Coming up to our stage then, our lovely judges, Sophie and Lulu. Both experienced cosplayers. That's what we tend to look for in a judge. And who wants the microphone? Is that not you? You don't want the microphone.
Right, hello everyone. Did we enjoy the masquerade? Come on. Did we enjoy the masquerade? Fantastic, that's what we like to hear. Now, all the entrants today have been absolutely fantastic, and we have had such a fantastic time judging everyone. But we have whittled it down. We've got a best costume, we've got best in performance, and we have two judges' awards as well. So, first and foremost, we'll do the judges' award for you, and we have chosen Megan Jennifer from League of Legends as the bittersweet Lulu. Is she still here? Small and purple, yes. Is she gone? If not, we do take contact details when they do fill out the form, so we can get in touch with her otherwise. If not, we'll move on. Lovely, so I'll let you do the next one for me.
Am I doing the other judge?
Yeah, the other judges. Okay.
The second judge's award is that Curdon?
Curdon, yeah.
Emma Curdon, Hellboy 2, Prince Nuada and Princess Nuala.
Well, I'm glad these guys are still here. Fantastic. And then we'll just jump straight into it. I'm going to do the best performance, and I absolutely love this. Not biased whatsoever. Fantastic. So the best performance is going to be Katie from The Little Mermaid as Ariel.
And best costume is Anna Perez as Star Fox Zero. No, Fox McCloud from Star Fox Zero.
Thank you very much.
Why? Why do you hate me? I'm lovely. I'm lovely.
Oh, there you go.
Aha! Hey! But we haven't found our bittersweet Lulu yet. Oh, that's so bittersweet. Okay, so that's our special mention judges award, our best performance and best costume. Would the four of you like to come to the front of the stage? Ladies and gentlemen, if you have your cameras out, these are the winners of the MCM Birmingham Comic Con Cosplay Masquerade here on Saturday in March 2016. Congratulations, of course, to everyone who took part, and big thanks to both of our judges, especially the one who's angry with me now. And of course, thank you to everyone that helps out and makes this worthwhile. We will be back at 3:30 tomorrow as well. And at 3:30 tomorrow...
Can I say, if they want feedback,
then if any masqueraders can hear me, if anyone wants to talk to the judges and get some feedback about their costume, the judges will also be happy to provide feedback. Thank you very much for watching our Cosplay Masquerade. Oh, we have one more group pose.